Hello student, today we are going to study concept from alcohols, which is very important and more frequently asked questions. Hope you get complete idea after this video, can be able to distinguish primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol by Victor Smear method. It is very important for all type of exam including medical, engineering and 12 board. Let us see primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol first. 1 degree, secondary 2 degree and tertiary 3 degree alcohol. So what is primary alcohol? In alcohol there is presence of OH and bonded with carbon. If this carbon bonded with only one carbon, then this is the primary alcohol. For example, CH3 methyl group, and here is 1-2 bond, so 2 hydrogen is bonded with carbon. So CH3CH2OH, this is the primary alcohol. It is example of primary alcohol. In generally we can write the methyl group, ethyl group, propyl group. So normally we represent by R, which is alkyl, and R CH2 and OH bonded carbon is 1 degree, so it is called primary alcohol. And 1 degree means it bonded with only one carbon, and R may be methyl, ethyl, propyl. Like if there is a ethyl group, then you can write CH3 CH2 CH2 OH. This is the alkyl group, ethyl group, and this carbon bonded with only one carbon. This is the 1 degree carbon, so OH bonded carbon is 1 degree, so it is called primary alcohol. In case of secondary alcohol, secondary alcohols, OH bonded carbon bonded with 2 alkyl group. For example, CH3 to methyl group, 1-2-3 bond, so carbon contains 4 bond, CHOH. So this is the 2 degree alcohol, because OH bonded carbon bonded with 2 carbon. Here this carbon is 2 degree, this carbon bonded with 2 carbon, so this is the 2 degree carbon. And general representation CHOH, you can write here R and here R. This R may be same or different, we can put here R prime. For tertiary alcohol, OH bonded carbon bonded with 3 carbon, then this carbon is 3 degree carbon, and this alcohol is called tertiary alcohol. And here is 1-2-3-4 bond, or carbon already fulfilled it bond, so there is no any hydrogen. And we can put here CH3 and here is CH3. This is the tertiary alcohol, and general representation for tertiary alcohol is COH. You can put here R and this R alkyl group may be same or different, so we can put R prime, double prime. So this is the primary alcohol, and this is secondary, and this is the tertiary alcohol. And if you ask distinguish between primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol, you can take general representation of alcohol, primary, secondary and tertiary. You can take this and this. But in some question they are given some IUPAC name or common name of the alcohol, and you have to ask distinguish them. So you have to use that molecular formula to distinguish primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol. For example, distinguish ethanol from propan-2-ol. It means you have to write this ethanol and this propanol, propan-2-ol, and to distinguish by Victor Smear method. Let us take an example, general formula for the primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol. For primary alcohol, RCH2OH. for secondary alcohol, R2CHOH, and for tertiary alcohol, R3COH. These are the general molecular formula for primary, secondary, and tertiary alcohol. In first, the given alcohol is first converted into its alkyl iodide, by treating it with phosphorus and iodine. All this alcohol treated with phosphorus and iodine, P plus I2. And it forms alkyl iodide. It means this OH is substituted by iodine, and this OH is also substituted by iodine, and this OH also substituted by iodine. So OH is removed and I is bonded here. So RCH2 I is formed here. R2CHI is formed here. R3CI is formed. These are all alkyl iodide. The alkyl iodide is then treated with silver nitrite. Silver nitrite, AgNO2. Here is also AgNO2. Here is also AgNO2. Silver nitrite, NO2. Then alkyl iodide is converted into its corresponding nitroalkane. Corresponding nitroalkane means, just here, this I is substituted by NO2 group. And form RCH2NO2. And here is also I is substituted by NO2 and form R2CHNO2. And in tertiary alcohol, in tertiary alkyl iodide, I is substituted by NO2, and these are all are nitroalkane. And this is the primary nitroalkane, secondary nitroalkane, and tertiary nitroalkane. This nitroalkane is then treated with nitrous acid. Nitrous acid is mixture of NaNO2 and HCl, and we can say HNO2 is a nitrous acid. Here is also HNO2. When this nitroalkane react with nitrous acid, then this carbon lost all the hydrogen and form water. Here 2 hydrogen is present in this carbon, so only 1 oxygen is required from HNO2, and removal of water and the remaining formula will be RC, and here is NO2. 2 hydrogen is removed from this carbon and 1 oxygen is removed from this HNO2, so here is only NO bond with nitrogen double bond. 2 hydrogen bond is removed, so double bond with nitrogen, and 1 oxygen is removed, remaining 1 oxygen bonded with O, and nitrogen bonded with O, and remaining 1 hydrogen. This is nitrolic acid. In secondary nitroalkane, there is also the same mechanism, but there is no 2 hydrogen, there is only 1 hydrogen. So R2C, this carbon lose 1 hydrogen, so need to bonded with 1 with nitrogen, single bond with nitrogen, and it is NO2 as it is, there is no change in other, and this hydrogen is removed. For formation of water, it requires H2, but here is only 1 hydrogen, and another hydrogen is from this HNO2 and 1 oxygen, so only remaining here NO double bond oh, oxygen required two bond, nitrogen required triple bond. So this is the this is pseudo nitrol, and in tertiary alcohol and tertiary nitro alkane do not react with HNO2 because there is no any hydrogen, there is no any hydrogen in carbon, and water will not remove or eliminate from this. So no reaction in this case, no reaction. Finally, when this nitrolic acid treated with alkali, NaOH, aqueous NaOH or QOH, NaOH, aqueous, and it is also NaOH, NaOH, sorry, aqueous, and here is also aqueous, NaOH, then what product will be formed? For primary alcohols, blood red coloration is appears, and for secondary alcohol, blue coloration is appear, and for tertiary alcohol, solution remain colorless. Presence of blood red coloration, presence of blood red, it indicates a primary alcohol. Presence of blue coloration indicates secondary alcohol, and presence of colorless solution, it indicates the tertiary alcohols. So very important concept for Victor's method, and we can simply write this HNO2 here, removal of water. So H2N here you can write O and N O H, H and O2. For removing of water, H2 require oxygen, so oxygen is written before nitrogen, and in this case one hydrogen, so need of another hydrogen and one oxygen, so N O, H2O is removed, this H2O is removed, and from this part H2O is removed, and there is no reaction. You can write HNO2 like this. This is the basic trick for the distinct use of primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol.